हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ नंबर सिस्टम कन्वर्जन फ्रॉम चैप्टर वन नंबर सिस्टम एंड कोड्स, सब्जेक्ट डिजिटल टेक्निक्स 22320. इन टुडेज कन्वर्जन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी बाइनरी टू ऑक्टल कन्वर्जन एंड बाइनरी टू हेक्साडेसिमल कन्वर्जन. सो विल स्टार्ट विद बाइनरी टू conversion. Now if we want to convert a binary number to octal number, then there are the certain steps. So the step one is the break the binary number into 3-bit groups starting from LSB. So if any binary number is given, we are here talking about integer part only now. So in that, the very first thing you are supposed to mark is LSB bit. And from that LSB bit, group 3 bits. Form of a group of 3 bits from LSB bit. Here, we'll check out one example I have shown here. The given example is 110101. It's a binary number. So check in this tabular form I have shown. So that number I have written as 110101. In that LSB bit is marked and MSB bit is marked. So the step one is start grouping into 3 bits, and you are going to start from LSB bit. So as shown by the arrow here. So from LSB bit, when we will start grouping 3 bits, so it becomes 101. From LSB bit and 011 from LSB bit side only to MSB bit. So after grouping these 3 bits, next step is to represent each 3 bit into its equivalent octal number. So here 101, this is the binary and its octal number, equivalent octal number is 5. 110, its equivalent octal number is 6, and that becomes 65. So 110101 binary number, its equivalent octal number is 65. Now whatever we have done in the last slide, their binary number was given but without any point. Binary point, there was no binary point in that, so that means it was having only an integer part. Now check out in this example, binary number is given 00101010 point 101010. It's a binary number, it is having integer part and a fractional part. So if such kind of binary numbers are given, then again the step remains same, start grouping into 3 bits. But now here you will start grouping from the decimal point as shown in the arrows. So if you check here, the decimal point is marked here as shown below, and from the decimal point the integer part grouping will start towards the left. So 3-bit grouping you will start, 3 bits you will group. So that is 110010, and 0 is left. So there is only a single bit left in that. And to group, we need 2 more bits so that it becomes 3 bits. So you are going to add 2 zeros on the left side so that it forms a group of 3 bits. If there is nothing, there is only a single, as there is only a single bit, so 2 more zeros you are going to add. Now for fractional part, you will start grouping from that binary point towards right. 3 bits you will take, and if you will check here, when you will start grouping 3 bits, 101 it is done, 001 it is done, but left only one single zero is left. So you are going to add 2 more zeros to form 3-bit groups. So always you have to add zeros if there are nothing, no number to form a group of 3 bits. So two zeros are added on this side, which is marked here. And then next step is represent each 3 bit groups into its equivalent octal number. Now here you should have the table, 3 bit binary table and a 4 bit binary table. So from 3 bit binary table you are going to check. So in that 110 corresponds to 6, 010 corresponds to 2, and 000 corresponds to 0. 101 corresponds to 5, 001 corresponds to 1, and 000 corresponds to 0. So therefore the final equivalent octal number is 26. It is actually 026.510, and that is your final octal number. So in this we have solved two examples of binary. One, it is having only integer part, and one, it is having integer part as well as fractional part. So the steps to be remembered are: form a group of 3 bits and represent each 3 bit groups with its equivalent equivalent octal number. Now these are the assignment questions to be solved. Solve it and send it to me. Now the next topic we are going to do here is binary to hexadecimal conversion. In the last topic we have done binary to octal conversion. Now we are going to do binary to hexadecimal conversion. So again, to be brushed up with the hexadecimal number system. Hexadecimal number system consists of 0 to 9 numbers, and then it is having alphabets from A, B, C, D, E, F, A to F. So this is to be remembered. So we'll start with the conversion. There are certain rules. Again, here what you are going to do is whatever the binary number is given, you have to first check out whether it is having only integer part or it is having integer part and a fractional part. So whatever binary number is given, step one is you have to break that binary number into 4 bits starting from LSB bit if it is having only integer part. So instead, in octal number, what we have done grouping of 3 bits. Here we are going to do grouping of 4 bits, and after grouping into 4 bits we are going to replace each 4 bit with its equivalent hexadecimal number from the 4 bit binary table. So here one example is given. Check out here. The example is 111101. So it is having only integer part. There is no fractional part. So you have to mark first LSB bit. After getting the LSB bit, you will start grouping from LSB bit towards MSB bit. So when you will start from LSB bit, you have to check out here. So LSB bit is 1, then comes 0, then 11. So these are the 4 bits. It is a group of 4 bits. Then after this, you will start with the next 4 bits. Now here you will find out that there are only 2 bits remaining, that is 11. So there are only 2 bits, but to form a group of 4 bits, 2 more bits are needed, and then you are going to add 2 zeros to form 4 bits. So after grouping, you are going to replace each that 4 bit with its equivalent hexadecimal number from the 4 bit binary table. So here 1101 represents 2 alphabet D. It is a 13 number. It comes 13, and 13 in hexadecimal number doesn't exist, but there is a alphabet D. Now the next number 0011 is nothing but 3. Sorry, here is a mistake. Okay, so here was a mistake there. It is 3D. 0011 represents two binary two hexadecimal number 3, and the final answer is 3D. We will solve one more example as shown here of binary to hexadecimal conversion. Now if you check out here, the given example is having integer number and a fractional number. So integer part and a fractional part, there is a binary point in between. So you're going to write the number as shown in this table, and you will start grouping into 4 bits from this point. But you have to go, for integer part, you have to go towards MSB bit side and start grouping into 4 bits. So from that point or towards MSB bit for integer part. So when you will start grouping, it will start from that point. So the number is 0110 and 110. Now here only last for integer part, it is only 3 bits. So you want 4 bits for grouping. So you have to add 10 on left side. Now on the fractional part, what again you are going to do is you will start grouping into 4 bits from that binary point, and the grouping is as shown. So there it is, 1010 and then 010. Now again here are 3 bits only, and you need to group into 4 bits. So you are going to add 10 to form 4 bits, and then after this the next step is to represent each binary 4 bits into its equivalent hexadecimal number. So here, so we'll start from this MSB bit side. 0011 represents 3, 0110 represents 6. Then on the fractional side, 1010 represents A, and 0100 represents 4. So the final answer is 36.A4. I hope you have understood binary to octal conversion and binary to hexadecimal conversion. So these are the examples to be solved for binary to hexadecimal conversion as an assignment. Thank you.